The new set of Senate leaders denies outside forces influenced the leadership change in the upper chamber. RG Cruz has tonight's top story.
Senate President Pro Tempore Jingoy Estrada declined to say what happened behind the scenes, but he made it clear Malacanang and House Speaker Martin Romualdez had no hand in the Senate's affairs. He also denies initiating the ouster of then-Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri.
Ang lumalabas kasi na balibalita sa labas na ako raw ang nag-instigate, ako raw nag-initiate nitong kudeta laban kay Senator Miggs. Hindi po totoo yan. I am denying it outright. I had no hand. I never initiated or instigated the ouster of Senate President Zubiri.
Senate President Francis Escudero gave his assurance the Senate remains independent. He also urged everyone to move on and start working.
Bakit hindi mo kapanipaniwala yung sinasabi ko? It's not so much for posterity. I'd rather focus on the unity of the Senate than to focus on what divided us to begin with. Huwag na natin angkatin yung mga sugat na yun.
The chairmanships of the Senate Committees on Ethics and Privileges, Finance, Tourism, Youth, Local Government, Urban Planning, Housing and Resettlement are now vacant after their former chairpersons resigned along with Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri. There will be a reshuffle of committee chairmanships at the Senate, and all these will be decided in a caucus on Wednesday.
Some of the committee heads, chairs, already signified their intention to resign, or some have already resigned. We're referring to several committees na wala pang ulo. So in the meantime, the vice chair would be in an acting capacity as the chairman. So tuloy-tuloy din yung mga hearing.
But the changes may not be that sweeping, according to the new Senate President.
Konti lang naman yung gagawin. Konti lang.
Obviously, in my case, I'm higher education. So obviously, that will be assigned some.
A member of the Zubiri-led bloc of Senator Joel Villanueva, Nancy Binay, Sani Angara, Sherwin Gachalian, JV Ejercito, and Lauren Legarda said they have yet to decide on what to do or if they will join the minority. For now, it's clear Senator Ronald De La Rosa will remain as the chairman of the Committee on Public Order and Dangerous Drugs, which is probing the PDEA leaks. Escudero won't stop De La Rosa from investigating the matter, which has dragged the names of the president and the first lady. But he does have this advice for De La Rosa.
Depende sa chairman, pero ang pinaalala ko lang sa kanya, tulad ng pinaalala ko sa unang pag-attend ko ng hearing, walang pumipigil sa kanya maghain ng resolusyon tungkol dito para walang issue kaugnay sa procedure. Pero yung motu proprio, ito ang kauna-unahan kasi sa kasaysayan nga ng Senado ng motu proprio, nakakatatlo-apat na. So pwede niyang ituloy anytime basta maghain na ng resolusyon.
De La Rosa explained his chairmanship and hearings have nothing to do with the change in the Senate presidency.
Tinanong ko ito kay Senator Chase kung talagang yan bang dahilan bakit kinudita si Senator Miggs dahil ba dyan sa hearing. Sabi niya, no, hindi yan kasi wala yan sa rason dito. Wala yan sa rason. Yun lang sabi sa akin, ha? Which, of course, it's up for you to, bahala na kayo.
De La Rosa also shared why he was in tears on Monday. He says he failed Zubiri because of his previous commitment to his PDP Laban party mates who already went with Escudero.
Kasi yung nakapirma ako before mag-start ang session, di ba? Pumasok ako doon. Tapos ngayon, nung sinaluduhan ako ni Miggs, eh talaga hindi ko napigilan, napaiyak ako.
Alam mo, I thought I've seen strange things in my political career. And this happens to be the strangest. Talagang, kung kahapon ako po ay heartbroken, then po ako ay dumbfounded. Talagang hindi ko ma-gets, hindi ko talaga maisip, hindi ko talaga mag-grasp yung pangyayari ngayon.
Pero nag-usap
at least,
kayo,
at least alam niya, na dinipensahan ko siya bilang isang chairman ng committee. At dahil dyan, nagkaroon po ng sakripisyo, ako po yung sakripisyo dyan, nawala po ako sa posisyon.
Mum's the word on the circumstances that led to the changes in the Senate, but Escudero did say senators signed individual resolutions of support and that he only started to campaign last Thursday and garnered the numbers on Sunday.
Sa akin, hindi na natin pag-usapan yung ano, kasi lalong mauungkat-ungkat at ayaw na natin makadagdag sa kung ano man ang makakasakit. So let's move forward.
Meantime, President Marcos extended his support to newly elected Senate President Francis Escudero. On social media, Marcos said, Senator Escudero's legislative record and commitment to public service have distinguished him as a dedicated leader. He also commended the Senate leadership of Senator Juan Miguel Zubiri. Marcos is confident the upper chamber will continue to prioritize transformative laws under Escudero's leadership. The senators were invited to dinner at the palace Tuesday evening. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.